Post-production is extremely nuanced with unique requirements. Many of the AI tools out there simply don't work for us. But what tools do, and how can you use them? In this episode of 5 Things, I'll introduce you to a few AI tools that you probably haven't heard of and that are just perfect for post-production. Let's get started. Generative AI is the big sexy right now, specifically creating audio, stills, and videos using AI. What's often overlooked, however, is how useful analytical AI is. In the context of video analysis, it would involve facial or location recognition, logo detection, sentiment analysis, and speech to text, just to name a few. And those analytical AI tools is what we'll focus on today. We'll start with small tools and then go big with team and facility tools. But I will sneak in some generative AI here and there for you to play with. Welcome to the forefront of post-production evolution with StoryToolKitAI, a brainchild of Octavian Motz. And with an epic name like Octavian, you'd expect something grand. He understood the assignment. StoryToolKitAI transforms how you interact with your own local media. Sure, it handles the tasks we've come to expect from AI tools that work with media, like speech-to-text transcription, but it also leverages zero-shot learning for your media. What's zero-shot learning, you ask? Imagine an AI that can understand and execute tasks that it was never explicitly trained for. StoryToolKitAI with zero-shot learning is like trying to play charades. It somehow guesses things right the first time. While I'm still standing there making random gestures, hoping someone will figure out that I'm trying to act out Jurassic Park and not just practicing my T-Rex impersonation for Halloween.
I can't reach my ears.
Powered by the goodness of ChatGPT, StoryToolKitAI isn't just a tool. It's a conversational partner. You can use it to ask detailed questions about your index content, just like you would talk with ChatGPT. And for you DaVinci Resolve users out there, StoryToolKitAI integrates with Resolve Studio. However, remember, Resolve Studio is the paid version, not the free one. Diving even nerdier, StoryToolKitAI employs various open source technologies, including the RN50x4 CLIP model for zero-shot recognition. CLIP, developed by OpenAI, stands for
layman's terms, none of that inside bull jargon that nobody understands.
Moving on. You know what one of my favorite aspects of StoryToolKitAI is that it runs locally. You get privacy, and with ongoing development, the future holds endless possibilities. Now imagine running newer or even bespoke analytical AI models tailored for your specific clients or projects. The power to choose and customize AI models? Well, who doesn't like playing God with a bunch of zeros and ones, right? Lastly, StoryToolKitAI is passionately open source. Octavian is committed to keeping this project accessible and free for everyone. On a larger scale, and on a personal note, I believe the architecture here is a blueprint for how things should be done in the future. That is, media processing should be done by an AI model, with its transparent practices, of your choosing, and can process media independently of your creative software. Or better yet, tie this into a video editing software's plugin structure. And then you have a complete media analysis tool that's local and using the AI model that you choose. Have you ever heard of 12 labs?
Hold up.
Don't confuse 12 labs with 11 labs, the AI voice synthesis company. 12 labs is another interesting solution that I think is poised to blow up, or at least be acquired. While many analytical AI indexing solutions search your content based on literal keywords, what if you could perform a semantic search? That is, using a search engine that understands words from the searcher's intent and their search context. This type of search is intended to improve the quality of search results. Let's say here in the US, we wanted to search for the term knob.
It's like the volume knob, yo.
Right. It's exactly like a volume knob, yo.
Other English speakers may be searching for something completely different.
And he's got a big knob.
Wait. Stop. That may not actually be the best way to illustrate this. Let's try something different.
And in order to do this, you would need to be able to understand video the way a human understands video. And what we mean by that is not only considering the visual aspect of video and the audio component, but the relationship between those two and how it evolves over time, because context matters the most.
Right now, 12 Labs has a free plan, which is hosted by 12 Labs. It's fairly generous. However, if you want to take deeper advantage of their platform, they also have a developer plan. 12 Labs tech can be used for tasks like ad insertion or even content moderation, like figuring out which videos featuring running water are depicting natural scenes like rivers and waterfalls or man-made objects like faucets and showers. With no insider info, I'd wager that 12 Labs will be acquired, as the tech is too good not to be rolled into a more complete platform. Next up, we have Curio Anywhere by Gray Meta, and it's one of the first complete analytical AI solutions for media facilities. Now, this isn't just a tagging tool. It's a pioneering approach to using AI for indexing and tagging your content using their localized models, and if you so choose, cloud models too. In addition to all of this, there's also a twist. See, traditionally analytical AI-generated metadata can drown you in data and options and choices, overloading and overwhelming you. Gray Meta's answer? A user-friendly interface that simplifies the search and audition process right in your web browser. This means briefly being able to see what types of search results are present in your library across all of the models. Is it a spoken word? Maybe it's the face of someone you're looking for. Perhaps it's a logo. And for you Adobe Premiere users out there, you can access all of these features right within Premiere Pro via Gray Meta's Curio Anywhere panel extension. Now let's talk customization. Curio Anywhere allows you to refine models to recognize specific faces or objects. Imagine the possibilities for your projects without days of you training a model to find that person. Connectivity is key, and Curio Anywhere nails it. Whether it's cloud storage or local data, Curio Anywhere's got you covered. And it's not just about media files either. Documents are also part of the package too. Here's a major win. Curio Anywhere's models are developed in-house by Gray Meta. This means no excessive reliance on costly third-party analytical AI services. But if you do prefer using those services, don't worry. Curio Anywhere supports those too via API. For those of you eager to delve deeper into Gray Meta and their vision, I had a fascinating conversation with Aaron Adell, president and CEO of Gray Meta. We talk about a lot of things, including Curio Anywhere, making coffee, and if the AI robots will take us over. It's time to get a little bit more low level with CodeProject AI Server, which handles both analytical and generative AI. Imagine CodeProject AI Server as Batman's utility belt. Each gadget and tool on the belt represents a different analytical or generative AI function designed for specific tasks. And just like Batman has a tool for just about any challenge, CodeProject AI Server offers a variety of AI tools that can be selectively deployed and integrated into your systems, all without the hassle of cloud dependencies. It includes object and face detection, scene recognition, text and license plate reading, and for funsies, even the transformation of faces into anime-style cartoons. Additionally, it can generate text summaries and perform automatic background removal from images. Now, you're probably wondering, how does this integrate into my facility or my workflow? The server offers a straightforward HTTP REST API. For instance, integrating scene detection in your app is as simple as making a JavaScript call to the server's API. This makes it a bit more universal than a proprietary standalone AI framework. It's also self-hosted, open source, can be used on any platform and in any language. It also allows for extensive customization and the addition of new modules to suit your specific needs. This flexibility means it's adaptable to a wide range of applications, from personal projects to enterprise solutions. The server is designed with developers in mind.
Developers, 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 developers.
Pinokio is a playground for you to experiment with the latest and greatest in generative AI. It unifies many of the disparate repos on GitHub. But let's back up a moment. You've heard of GitHub, right? Most folks in the post-production space don't spend much time on GitHub. It's for
developers, 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 developers.
It's what developers use to collaborate and share code for almost any project you can think of. GitHub is where cool indie stuff, like AI, starts before it goes mainstream. Yes, you too can be a code hipster by using Pinokio and GitHub, and you can experiment with various AI services before they go mainstream and become so yesterday. As you can imagine, if GitHub is for programmers, how can non-coding types use it? Pinokio is a self-contained browser that allows you to install and run various analytical and generative AI applications and models without knowing how to code. Pinokio does this by taking GitHub code repositories, called repos, and automating the complex setups of terminals, Git clones, and environmental settings. With Pinokio, it's all about easy one-click installation and deployment, all within its web browser. Diving into Pinokio's capabilities, there's already a list chock full of diverse AI applications, from image manipulation with Stable Diffusion and Face Fusion, to voice cloning and AI-generated videos with tools like Kai and Animate Diff. The platform covers a broad spectrum of AI tools. Pinokio helps to democratize access to AI tools by combining ease of use with a growing list of modules. As AI continues to grow in various sectors, platforms like Pinokio are vital in empowering users to explore and leverage AI's full potential. The cool part is that these models are constantly being developed and refined by the community. Plus, since it runs local and it's free, you can learn and experiment without being charged per revision. Every week, there are more analytical and generative AI tools being developed and pushed to market. Have I missed one? Let me know what they are and what they do in the comments section below, or hit me up online. Subscribing and sharing would be greatly appreciated. Until the next episode, learn more, do more. Thanks for watching. Come on, guys, one more round.